Hello and welcome to the digital foyer for Sunday, August 1st. I hope I have the date right. I am Matt Vaughn, the communications coordinator here at St. Benedict Parish. And this week in the digital foyer, I am joined by Father Simon Lobo on my right. How are you doing, Father Simon?
Hello, I'm doing great.
You're doing great. You sound great.
Thank you.
There we go. And on my left, homilist, associate pastor.
It's me.
Nodder. Father Alex Galati. How you doing, Father Alex?
You know, living the dream.
There you go.
This is it. Yeah. I've arrived. This is what it looks like, people. This is what it looks like.
Yeah. A man at the top of his game. It's true. It's true. Hope you're at the top of your game, man. Too, after a great Sunday Mass here at St. Benedict Parish. So we're going to have a little bit of fun here in the digital foyer. You're going to ask some questions. Actually, specifically, you are going to ask some questions.
Yeah.
And I'm going to send those questions over to Father Simon, over to Father Alex. Yeah. You can ask very serious questions. You can ask very fun questions.
You can ask questions that I can send over to Matt Vaughn, actually. Yeah. So feel free to ask Matt really tough questions about WrestleMania trivia, perhaps.
Sure, yes.
That's an area of expertise.
Yes, it's true. You said volley, and I was thinking, you know, I was going to mention the Olympics, and you're going to volley it back to me.
Oh, yes.
Anyway, it's a very good one there. Actually, that leads to my first question. Have you guys been watching the Olympics at all? We're in the throes of it. It's the 2020 Olympics in 2021. It's kind of fun.
No.
Okay, that's fine.
I don't know. Does this make me, like, anti-patriotic? I don't know.
I don't know.
Can't get into the Olympics. Like, I don't know. I've never been able to. Like, I've
Father
just
Alex,
never...
anti-Olympian.
Like, I love Olympians. I love what they do. I think amazing feats of excellence and everything. But, like, you know, and I watch, like, World Cup soccer and all that kind of thing, but I just can't get into the Olympics.
They have soccer at the Olympics, though, too. They have men's, they have women's soccer, they have both.
Yeah, it's not quite the same.
Okay, interesting. Doesn't like Olympic soccer. That's, I don't know.
Well, after Italy won the Euro Cup, it starts to...
Nothing else really matters.
That's right.
So, Father Simon, you can take
Who cares about the rest of the world?
You can take the very easy position and say, I like the Olympics. And then
I like the Olympics. I also haven't watched very much, though. We don't have cable.
Have you watched any Olympics?
I watched at least one YouTube clip of a swimming event.
Okay.
Good.
And I don't know if I watched it the full 3 minutes, but I watched part of it.
That's good.
I did check the medal count yesterday.
Sure.
So.
Oh yeah.
Or the other day.
That's good. How were we doing in your eyes?
I think we were 14th in the world, 12th or 14th in the world. So, I have no idea.
I mean, Summer Olympics in Canada, not always
we're there. Kind of, G8, okay, one of the largest economies in the world. I think what would we land? We'd probably be around that in terms of, you know, size of the economy, in terms of population.
You think we're one of the largest
size.
Economies in the world?
Well, we were back, those was what the G8 countries were. Now we'd be probably top 15, I would think.
Sure.
So, I'd say we're punching at around our weight. We're not, I don't think we're... Right. Exceeding anyone's expectations.
Well, they don't have economics in the Olympics, that's the problem.
And the other problem, I think, for Canada.
Yeah. Let's talk about Canada's problems. Let's get into this.
Love Canada's got all of our Canadian Olympians, athletes. Way to go. Smarter, faster, stronger, higher. But I also feel like there's not a lot of summer in our country. And so it's hard to do well in the Summer Olympics. I feel like we do a lot better in the Winter Olympics because that is the season that is most predominant in the True North Strong and Free. So just wanted to point that out.
Yeah.
But way to go. I was listening to a podcast actually this week, and one of the people took issue with the Olympic bloat, how there's just so many different events and, they were hating on rhythmic gymnastics. I don't personally have... a horse in that fight. However,
palm a horse in that race.
I would say, you know, and the other event that they mentioned was the triple jump. Is that where like a hop, skip, and a jump?
That's like a classic Olympic event. I could see people being like, oh, there's too many swimming events. I'm not saying that, but I could see people saying that.
You just said
that.
You just said that.
They need to go back. They need to go back to ancient Greece, the original Olympics.
Right.
It was running and wrestling.
Yeah, but the running events were like run until you die. So I'm kind of glad we got away from that.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
I could get into those Olympics for sure.
Yeah, that's right. Now, I'm going to point out here. So our own children's minister, Laura, is pointing out you do not need cable to watch the Olympics.
Yeah, Father Simon.
CBC Gem, so you can get that. That's an app you can get here.
Thank you, Laura. Thank you. I am not up on the ways of this world. So thank you.
Father Simon, yeah.
He's not long for this world.
Yeah. Father Simon spends most of his days off. He sits on a pillar in the desert.
Simon the Stylite. Simon the Stylite.
Yes,
love exactly. That.
After the saint that I was named after. Yes, indeed.
So you were named after a desert hermit.
I was actually named after a famous. A lot of people assume I was named after Simon Peter, or Simon the Zealot, another one of the 12. I was actually believe that I was named after
Simon
the taxidermist, who you can read about in the Acts of the Apostles.
There we go.
So,
Father Oxford thought you were named after Paul Simon, which is an interesting choice. It's certainly possible. Has anyone named their child after you, Father Simon? Because you're a priest, you're beloved in the communities you serve, and you're back in Ottawa, you're at St. Maurice, and now you're here.
Several spiritual children who
Little Simon's
have
running
a first
around.
Name or a middle name. In fact, I'm going to give a shout out to my nephew, Joshua Simon, who's the eldest of my nephews, about to turn, let's just say, 11 on August the 6th. I think that is correct. Yeah. Way to go, Joshua. Early happy birthday. And he's definitely, his middle name is Simon.
There we go. So now, Father Alex, he's often touted as a toddler priest. I don't know if we're kind of getting closer to maybe like a small child priest. I don't know.
Small child
priest. I don't know how that works. I don't know. Toddler. Yeah. I don't know. Is there a difference between toddler and child? I don't know.
You're the
super toddler.
You're the dad.
I don't know.
You've got
She's like
kids.
A little person now. You're like a little person priest.
Like a little person priest.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Has anyone named any Alexanders going around? Or Alexandrias?
So I know of one or two. So this is really interesting. I think two middle names. I think I have two middle names named after me.
Okay.
So at my ordination, so they say, there's a special grace attached to a priest's first blessing,
right?
Which is kind of any blessing he gives in the first year of his ordination.
Right. They've kind of, I feel like they stretch that a little bit.
Yeah, it's a little bit more. So anyway, so there's like my ordination, there's like a lineup of people, all the people who are at my ordination, it's like you're standing there for hours, like literally like 3 hours I pray over people, give them my first blessing.
The reception for a priest's ordination is not the
They're
most
not
fun
enjoyable
time for, a priest.
For the priest, let me tell you that. It's work, it's hard labor.
They're not hooking up sandwiches with you,
but
unfortunately.
But two people came to my ordination, received my first blessing from me. Both of them had been struggling to conceive, some of them for years, actually. Mm. And both of them attribute their conception to trace it to that blessing. And so both of them have named their middle children after me.
There you go.
Now, of course, it's not me. It's the Lord who healed them. But
yes.
Just really kind of, it's kind of neat.
So, there we go. So I like that. There we go. Kind of a silly question that turned into something a little bit more profound.
There you go.
I like that.
Wow.
Question here. A question from Nadine asks, are we going to be going mask-free soon in church? Father Simon, what do you say about that? I don't know if it's,
I don't know if it's
a Father Simon decision,
you
really.
You should probably ask Dr. Strang, because I don't know the answer to that question.
Right.
I know other neighboring provinces have been lifting restrictions, and so that's exciting. That bodes well, I think, and I my understanding is we're on track. Things are low case counts, high
vaccination
rates.
Yeah.
So
I'm thinking
so
about wearing once we no longer have to wear a mask. I'm just going to start wearing a Darth Vader mask.
Sure.
Changing my old one for a new one.
Change it up a little bit.
Yeah,
I like that as an idea.
Yeah, for sure.
That works.
I think it should be a thing.
Yeah. I don't know, and I don't know about
some people. Yeah. I'm not saying this applies to you, Father X, but some people actually look better in a mask, and so you might just want to just aesthetically, you might just want to keep it on.
For some people, the problem is this area. Generally, it's true. That's right. Yeah, I know that the Delta variant is something people are concerned about, so I don't know. Masks could be affected by that, so keep track of that in the news. I genuinely don't know what that looks like or anything like that too. So still unpredictability during COVID. So.
We don't know what.
Yeah.
We're on the journey. We are in the middle of the journey.
That's right.
But God is providing for us.
Right.
So that's the main take-home point.
That's Father
right,
Alex
Father Alex?
Right. Right. Is that what I said?
roughly.
You said several things.
I said lots of things.
That's right.
I don't know. Maybe there's something in there worth taking. I don't know.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Now, let's stop talking about what you're saying, and let's talk about what you're wearing. On your feet, every week on Sunday, we check to see what the priests are wearing sock-wise on their feet to see if they've upped their game. They wear funny socks every week. We have a little head-to-head competition. Last week, it was a very stiff competition. There was four people, four sets of socks. Father Simon had shawarma. Father Alex had donuts. Deacon David, our departed Deacon David, who's,
he's still alive.
He's not dearly departed.
He's not dead. He is not
dead.
He is in Dartmouth. That is a common issue for people in Dartmouth. They're not dead. It's fine. And Patty, his wife as well, also had the socks. Now, Deacon David had St. Benedict Parish Divine Renovation socks. Patty had llama socks. Patty won. Patty's llama socks are very popular.
Patty always wins.
Yeah, I think there was a big, people like that. So, Father Simon, Father Alex, let's see this. We'll start with you this week, Father Alex. You got sock-wise there.
All right. Well, even though I said I'm not into the Olympics, nevertheless, I am Canadian, so I do support our Olympic athletes with my Canada socks.
There we go.
Oh, got the maple leaf.
Is there a bear paw on there? What is
that? Yeah, it's a bear paw. I got Canada goose on there. I don't know what that is.
Canoe. It's a canoe.
I got the Mountie hat, you know? So, hey.
And a maple leaf.
Go Canada, right?
There we go.
Go Canada.
Maybe a little bit more believable before I asked about the Olympics, but there we go.
I haven't been tracking, but I am going for Canada.
You're cheering for Canada.
Right. That's true.
As opposed to a different country. That's great.
San Marino.
That is patriotic of you. Well, it's the long weekend here in Nova Scotia. Natal Day tomorrow.
That's right.
I figured I'd wear these beautiful sailing socks, which were given to me by I can't remember who. So thank you, mystery person. But just a wonderful activity to enjoy on a long weekend. Unfortunately, I think tomorrow is going to be pouring rain. So hopefully, if you're a sailor, you are not made of sugar, as I am.
There we go. Sugar Father Simon. So, okay, that now it's time to vote, really. So you can either go with the sailing summer leisure socks that Father Simon has, or you can go with the Canada socks of Father Alex Kalani.
If you also support Canada in the Olympics, you have to vote for me, basically.
Always likes to attach all sorts of things to that. Anyway, feel free to vote. You can vote ahead now in the comments. And now we're going to throw it over to SV Kids Online Church with Laura, so take it away.